Next, please give a warm welcome to Abbott's Chairman and Chief Executive Officer, Robert Ford.
Well, good morning, and I'm excited to be here with all of you at Health because this is a group that understands the potential for technology to move us from a world where we think about care only when something is wrong to a world where we proactively keeping ourselves healthy. A world where we, as consumers, can better speak the language of our bodies in a way we can understand without needing to go to medical school, that allows us to have even better conversations about our health with each other and with our doctors, creating a true healthcare system rather than a sick care system we have today. And the potential for this future, one where our body's information is clear, it's understandable, where we can make better informed decisions at our fingertips, this is what inspires us here at Abbott, a future that pairs health and technology and puts us in greater control. And I'm very excited to say that that future is here. Now, I'm biased, I get it, but I wouldn't be on stage here if I wasn't convinced that Abbott is gonna play a big role in this transformation. And I'm here to tell you about where we're headed and to share how this transformation is already happening. Today, this means advances like connected medical devices that send your health data to your doctor, to your phone, biowearable sensors that offer real-time insights to what's happening inside your body, and tests that give you answers fast and in your home or wherever you may be. Advances powered by digital technology are now unlocking previously unimaginable possibilities in healthcare. And you just think about it. We have more technology and more information about our health and our bodies on our phones, on our wrists, at our disposal than we've ever had before. We've got access to hundreds of apps, devices that tell us how many steps we take, how long we slept, whether sleep was good, and what our heart rate is, and so on. But how often does that technology help us change our behavior in a sustainable way to keep us healthy or to help us improve our health? Information, yeah, it's powerful, data is powerful, but information that's understandable, that helps us make decisions in a way that we can maintain for the long term. Now, I believe that that's life-changing. So how do we do that? And that's the question that drives us at Abbott every day. And the answer is gonna help define the future of healthcare. Healthcare companies like Abbott have invaluable experience. We know how to innovate new products based on science. We know how to conduct clinical trials. We know how to work with regulators to ensure the product is effective and safe. And we're trusted to provide products that do what they are intended to do. But healthcare companies have a problem. We're so steeped in scientific and medical expertise that we never really learn how to talk to or with regular people. And at Abbott, we're working on changing that, getting out of our own way and putting the consumer and the healthcare experience they deserve at the center of everything that we do. We're taking medical and scientific information that we used to post on a website or an app where we expected consumers to figure out how to absorb it themselves. And we're working to translate that information, including their health data, into people speak rather than healthcare company corporate speak. And do it in a way that's easily digestible and more relevant to them, empowering them to have more productive conversations with their doctors, and importantly, to make decisions about their health that can lead to lasting behavior change. We know we have a lot of work to do to be great at this, but that's exactly what we're doing, because people need us to be great, and they will demand it. And we're working hard to transition to a system that focuses on keeping us healthy rather than treating us only when we're sick. A healthcare system that's more responsive, more connected, and more tailored to our needs in a language that we can all understand. And if that's hard to imagine, I get it. But the good news is that it's already happening, and we're proud to be leading the way. For example, in May, the FDA approved Assert IQ. And this is our cardiac monitor that gives people and their doctors a new long-term way to monitor heart rhythm irregularities. And instead of a more invasive surgical implant, the insertable monitor rests just under your skin and above the heart. It also securely connects to an app on your phone via Bluetooth and can transmit real-time data to the doctor or your clinic. People can go into the app and identify when they're experiencing symptoms and what those symptoms feel like. Input that can help their doctors better diagnose any potential problems. And some of our models of this device can actually allow a clinician to remotely adjust the device's settings to optimize performance without requiring somebody to go to an office visit. And unlike a watch or a device that can only monitor part of the time and doesn't have the same precision, Assert IQ monitors 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and can last for years. So why does this matter? Living with an abnormal heart rhythm can be scary. We're trying to take away that fear and give people the security and confidence of knowing they're connected to their care team and that their symptoms can be monitored in real time. We're also trying to change the entire treatment paradigm for people living with slower than normal heartbeats. And this connectedness and the immediacy and the flexibility that it offers, this is the future of healthcare. It extends beyond the hospital walls and gives you the power to live your life and optimize your care. Another example of this empowering connected care experience was the development of FreeStyle Libre technology. And this is our market-leading continuous glucose monitor, or CGM sensor. Today, approximately 5 million people living with diabetes around the world rely on this device every day to manage their diabetes. And we believe that tens of millions of people living with diabetes can benefit from this breakthrough. But Libre's success story started as a failure. And we often dismiss failures. But for me, they're really the greatest source of learning. Our first continuous glucose monitor was launched in 2008, and we called it FreeStyle Navigator. But it wasn't a sustainable product. It was too clunky, it was bulky, it was difficult for people to use, and it cost a lot. So we did something that's hard for companies to do. We looked ourselves in the mirror and we admitted defeat. We said we needed to be better and to do better. So we discontinued Navigator and went back to the drawing board and executed on a set of principles that gave birth to Libre. And I remember some of those design principles now. One of them was Fisher Price friendly, and the other one was priced at a latte a day. And that vision is now paying off. We're now on our third generation FreeStyle Libre 3. It's the smallest, most comfortable, accurate sensor, and it's part of the most widely used CGM portfolio in the world. It's also the most studied sensor, and more importantly, it's priced at one-third of the cost of our competitors. And it delivers. Studies have shown that it can significantly reduce A1C levels, a measure of a severity of diabetes, and it increases the amount of time people with diabetes spend in a normal glucose range during the day. It also reduces acute diabetes complications, and it showed a 67% reduction in hospitalizations amongst people with type 2 diabetes. And most recently, we published data that shows that people using GLP-1 medications for their diabetes are using the device with great results. And because of the difference it's making for so many, last year, FreeStyle Libre was named the best medical technology of the last 50 years by the Galien Foundation. But we didn't stop there. We listened, we observed, and we continue to learn. And one thing we learned from our experience with Libre was that there were a lot of consumers who did not have diabetes that were interested in using this device. They weren't interested in using Libre to know how much insulin or medications to take. They were interested to learn about their bodies and how they reacted to different types of foods or other day-to-day activities. And that set us on a path that traditional healthcare companies don't usually focus on. How to help the healthy who want to stay healthy. So we set out to help healthy people better understand their metabolism, because metabolism is key to overall health. It directly affects everything from weight management to energy, sleep, mood, and mental acuity. And understanding your body's glucose is key to understanding your overall metabolic health and living healthier. And while we had the perfect platform with Libre and all of its benefits, we knew that we had to change and think differently if we wanted to embark on this quest. We had to get out of our own way and learn how to develop a superior consumer experience tailored for a healthy person who isn't dependent on our technology for their health. So, we're creating a new consumer biowearable that not only tracks your glucose levels, but using AI delivers a personalized coaching plan to help you develop healthier habits and motivate you to do what I believe is the hardest thing, how to modify and adapt your behaviors and habits. So we call this Lingo because it helps you speak the language of your body and what it's telling you. It's not a futuristic stuff. This has actually been released. Lingo's actually been released in the UK, and we intend to make it available across the globe, including here in the US, where we plan to submit to the FDA by the end of the year. So what is Lingo? How does it work, and how is it different from Libre? Well, studies have shown that flattening your glucose curve and keeping it from spiking and dipping leads to improved energy, mood, focus, sleep, and helps reduce those unpredictable cravings. So Lingo starts by establishing a baseline reading of your body's glucose levels and the fluctuations through a sensor you wear at the back of your arm. The tech then assesses how your diet, exercise, sleep, and other factors affect your glucose. And that is unique to each person. The coaching algorithm then highlights areas for improvement, provides insightful actions and recommendations, and an individualized plan of action that we believe will help people make better decisions. And core to this coaching platform is something that we call the Lingo Count. So how does the Lingo Count work? Well, the Lingo biosensor tracks your glucose in real time, and it assigns each glucose spike a value. The more you spike, the more Lingo counts you accrue. And your goal each day is to not go over the Lingo count. And the Lingo count's not static. The target evolves as you evolve. Each week, Lingo identifies focus areas for you to work on and then assigns a new daily Lingo count for you to target. And you see, what I love about this approach is that it translates all the complexity of glucose variability, all that science, into a metric that's easy and understandable. And for all the geeks out there like me that like all the data, you can have access to all the stats, you have access to all the graphs, all the pie charts, everything that you want is in there. But what I really like is that we've translated it into one simple metric, and we believe that it's this simplicity that can give the biggest impact on behavior modification. And there's also helpful content that you can access on the app, content from fitness, eating, different types of food that are best suited for you. And all those, and all that changes week by week. And these recommendations are tailored. They're personal to you. It's not an estimation, it's not an aggregation. This is your body talking to you in real time, and Lingo is there to translate, to be your personal metabolic coach. Now, I began using Lingo a few months back as part of a clinical wear experience, and I really feel better connected to my body and my choices. Of course, nobody's perfect. I still make poor choices, but I can see the implications of my choices, and it's that accountability that, for me, has impacted my decision and my behavior. So let me show you a little bit about my own experience. The first thing you see when you open the Lingo app. It shows my Lingo count that's allotted for me for the day and how many points I've already used. So in this case, I was allotted 75 points and I had already used 62 of them. Okay, and this was just before dinner, so I knew I had to make a smart choice if I wanted to stay in that 75 count range. You can also see the colored screen. And this is a pinkish purple color, and it shows that because of that color that my glucose is spiking. There's a different color when your glucose is stable. So as soon as I open the app, I already have a sense of what's going on. And the app on the home screen lets me know that. If I swipe up, I can actually see the glucose trace. And I can choose between 6, 12, and 24 hours. Here I chose 12. And this is where you get to see the AI algorithm identifying the spikes and assigning points to each one. And the points are assigned based on how high your glucose spikes, how fast it spikes, and how long it takes to come down. And I also can log. I can log food, exercise, and other factors like stress. And this is super important because logging makes the algorithm even more personal to you. And I learned that when I exercise, I actually spike, but that's a good spike. So when I log that I'm exercising, the algorithm will not count that spike towards my lingo count. And the report feature is pretty rich. One that I like shows me at the end of each week, not only how I did versus the lingo count goal, okay, but it also tells me what time of day I'm using most of my lingo count. And in this case, as you can see, my area of focus is between morning and afternoon, where you can see I'm consuming the majority of my points. And then I can also interact with the Discover feature, where I can learn about what impacts my metabolism from food, exercise, and other tips. I found myself interacting a lot with this feature on a daily basis. And the content here is bite-sized, it's snapshot, it's quick reads. And if you're a little competitive like I am, you can see how you compare to others of your age. Based on my lingo count, the curve shows my progress, how my progress compares to others, giving me a visual incentive to reach my goal week over week, your provincial kick in the butt, to move towards my age group. Now, this has been my experience, but we're already getting really positive feedback from these early users in the UK, and this gives me even more confidence and motivation that we're on the right track. So the intent here was not necessarily to do a product demo. I'm not the right person to do that, but I am proud of what my team and the journey that they've been on to develop this. Rather, what I wanted to do was to share how we're thinking about this at Abbott, about the potential of health and tech converging, a future where people have a window into their body, access to real-time information about how it's working, a much greater understanding of how to positively impact their health. We believe that access to this kind of knowledge will motivate us to act, to make better decisions in the best interest of our health and wellness. And if we can make the experience intuitive, even enjoyable and gratifying, we can affect behavior change and create healthier people and societies. Now, we will absolutely continue to develop products that help people who have a medical condition, just like we've been doing for 135 years. But we are gonna utilize all of our pioneering science, know-how, and the trust that we've built with the healthcare professionals, hospitals, and labs, and bring that to the consumer. We will create a new experience of health where we become people in greater control, taking action to help ourselves rather than patients waiting to get sick before we act. This is where we believe the future of health is headed, and we know other companies are heading there too, and I want to encourage our peer healthcare companies to keep going. It requires courage, but it's going to make a huge difference for the people that we're all here to serve. In this future, we can all stay healthy longer, so we can live our best and fullest lives. And when we do that, everybody wins. So thank you.
Thank you, Robert.